Good morning, everyone. Today I'll be making Pasi Paruppu Sambar, which is nothing but Moong Dal Sambar. It's not a sambar, it's more like a dal, but we call it sambar at our home because we eat it with idli or dosa or chapati. This is not to be eaten with rice, but you can eat it with rice. Nobody's going to say anything about it. The main ingredient that you would be using is Moong Dal, which is yellow split peas, the little one. So I just washed it and I have let it drain it. I just washed it and it is draining here. Let me go over the ingredients before I start. We need a lot of tomatoes because we are not using tamarind in this. I have used 3 medium-sized tomatoes. If you have large ones, just use 2. Any cooking oil. 5 garlic cloves. We love a lot of garlic. And when you add garlic, it helps with digestion. Whenever you make any dal item, any lentil, it's suggested that you add garlic. And green chilies, I added 5 of these. And shallots, 6 of these. But if you don't have shallots, it's fine. Use just regular onion, big onion, half of that. And some dried curry leaves. Cumin seeds, mustard seeds, salt, turmeric powder and hing. Hing is nothing but asafoetida or perungayam. I'm going to make this in instant pot today. In the meantime, I have already started my kettle and it has hot boiling water. I'll tell you why I need hot boiling water in a minute. So let's go into the recipe. So I will be using a 3-quart instant pot today. You can use any size instant pot, doesn't matter. It's still the same rules and the same instructions. I'm going to first turn on the instant pot in a saute mode because we will be first frying off a few things. Let me go ahead and add some oil. This is more like an eyeballing of whatever you do. So just add oil, let it wait for it to heat up. I'll be adding cumin seeds, 1 teaspoon, and 1 teaspoon mustard seeds. So now we'll be adding curry leaves, shallots, green chilies, and the garlic. Just dump all this in together. You don't have to wait. We'll be adding the tomatoes. All in at once. Don't worry about. You don't have to wait for it to saute or anything. Just go ahead and add 1 teaspoon of salt, 1 teaspoon of hing, and 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric powder. This dish is more like a dump and go kind of a dish. Don't worry about it. It will cook when we pressure cook it. Like I said, the first step to this will be for you to wash this. I already did that. And then dump it in here. So remember I said we need hot water. This is why we need hot water. I'm going to pour this and I'll tell you why. So I'm adding about 3 cups of hot water. So the reason I'm adding hot water is it will fasten the process. So it's going to speed up the process of the dal, cooking of the dal, and it will also help us maintain the temperature of the instant pot Otherwise, it will drop down again to a colder temperature and then it has to come back. You know, instant pot works only with pressure, right? So you have to wait for the pressure to build up. If you add hot water, it will actually make it faster. So let me put the lid on. Make sure the vent is in sealing position. Look at that, it's in sealing position. And I'm going to cancel this saute mode. Click pressure cooker. It is in 10 minutes now. I'll show you. Let's say if it is in a different one, okay? Let's say if it's in normal and 35. You just keep pressing the pressure cooker mode until it comes to high and 10 minutes. That's it. After it's done cooking, I'll show you. It doesn't matter how long you cook for. Even if you let it go for a long time, it will be okay because it's going to be a soupy consistency anyways. So you cannot actually overcook it. So it's fine. Don't worry. And make sure you do not use the keep warm mode. This is the using of keep warm mode and this is not using of it. So we don't want to keep it in keep warm because it will continue cooking. This will help it to release pressure naturally, but it doesn't matter. You can even release it naturally if you want to do it quickly. So I'll come back to you when it's cooked. So it's been 10 minutes. I actually allowed it to release naturally because I had something to do, but you can always release it by releasing the vent here if you have to do it urgently. So let's open it. It will look like this. So I'm going to turn it back on saute mode for just like a fraction of seconds. See, it will look like it has not come together. But don't worry, just take a ladle, like a spoon or a ladle or a something, or even a masher if you want. Just take that and then mix it up. At this point, you have to check for salt, okay? I'm going to be making dosa to be eaten with this. I'll show you how it looks when it's served with dosa. I like it tangy, that's why I added 3 tomatoes. If you don't like it tangier, you can always reduce it. This can be saved in the fridge and had with anything you like for up to couple of weeks. This is perfectly fine as a pre-cooked meal. You can always keep some. You can even freeze some and then keep it ready for a later time. This is a very versatile dish. You can always use it as a substitute for regular dal for rice too, but I don't like to eat it with rice. That's why I don't do that. This literally took me like 10 minutes to make. It did not take me a lot of time. And if you feel like you need it early in the morning, you can always do the step, first step, dump everything, turn it on, put it on a delay start overnight, and then come back in the morning and it will be ready for you. So this is very, very forgiving. You cannot overcook it. You will not make a mistake. So don't worry if you're beginning to cook now and you're wondering if I want to do something new. This is the dish that you need to start with. It's you can garnish it with coriander leaves. I'll do that in a minute. And I will be making dosa for this. I also want you to know that there are other recipes that are coming soon. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and like this video. Click the notification button so that you'll know as soon as I post any new video. Share it with your friends. And this is a very, very, very easy dish. If I can cook, anyone can cook. So do not wait. Try this recipe. Let me know how it is. Happy cooking and thank you for watching.